Good morning to all of you. Now in this exercise, let us see how to simulate distillation columns. In fact, one of the very popular and comprehensive model available in Aspen happened to be with respect to a distillation column. Now, the RadFrac model, though it is a rating model, is quite comprehensive and can handle a lot of situations, including chemical reactions taking place within the distillation column. So in other words, you will be able to use this RadFrac model for rating reactive distillation columns. And in this entire exercise, we are going to only concentrate on distillation columns. To start with, I would like to demonstrate how to design a distillation column using a shortcut model, then followed by a more rigorous model that is available to perform rating calculations using RadFrac model. Now let me take up the first problem. Though I have taken a simple example involving a binary system, the procedure is exactly going to be the same even though you have a large number of components. Now this particular system is consisting of methanol 36.8%, water 63.2%, the feed flow rate is given, the pressure of the column is known, and the condition of the feed is saturated liquid, and you are required to use a reflux ratio of 1.3 times the minimum reflux ratio. And you are required to separate such that 98% of methanol that is entering into the column should be going into the top product. And similarly, only 1% of water that is entering into the column can be allowed into the top product. Obviously, the balance 2% methanol and 99% water will have to be obtained in the bottom product. After simulating the column, you are also required to perform a sensitivity analysis. Remember, we are trying to design a binary distillation column using this particular example. Now let me demonstrate how to do this using Aspen. Now as is the case, the first step happened to be declare the various components that you are going to use in the simulation. So we have two components here, methanol and water. So having specified the components, you can go to the next input screen wherein you are required to choose a proper property model. Let me choose something like Chavo Cedar. Then go to the next input screen. So go to simulation environment. Now you can see under columns, you have quite a large number of models available. For example, if you see this DSTWU, this is shortcut distillation design using Bin Underwood Gilliland method. This is shortcut rating, distillation rating using Edmist method. This RadFrac, rigorous two or three phase fractionation for single columns, models, absorbers, strippers. It can handle ideal, non-ideal systems, azeotropic systems, reactive distillation. So this is quite capable. Now similarly, you have other columns, extractor, multi-fractionator, so on and so forth. Now to start with, as I said, because we are interested in going with a design problem, let me take this shortcut distillation design model. Remember, this is only a shortcut model, may not be very comprehensive, may not be very accurate, but we will be able to see how to improve its accuracy once you have some preliminary data obtained by simulating or by designing using this particular shortcut model. Now there is one feed, and similarly there is a top product and a bottom product. Now let me rename for convenience. Let me consider this as feed. This is top product. This is bottom product. So having provided the connectivity to this model, now we will be in a position to go to the next input screen. Now remember, this is a design problem. Now try to distinguish clearly the kind of inputs that you will be specifying for a rating problem as well as a design problem. Now we were given the condition of the system, the vapor fraction, the saturated liquid, vapor fraction is zero. The pressure of the column, okay, let me change the unit system to English. So the pressure of the column is 18 psia. The total flow rate is given to be, in terms of mass, 120,000 lb per hour. And the composition, this being a liquid phase, I'll take it as mass fractions, 0.368, 36.8% methanol, and the balance is water, 63.2. Now you can see the feed has been specified. We were able to address the degrees of freedom required for specifying this feed. Now we will be able to go to the next input screen. Now this is with respect to the block. Now you can see one of these column specifications is mandatory. Especially when you are trying to design the column, we may be required to find out the number of stages. So if you give the number of stages for the desired separation, it will calculate the reflux ratio. Or if you specify the reflux ratio, it will try to calculate what is the number of stages required. Now remember, molar reflux ratio, if the value that you are providing here is greater than zero, then it is the actual reflux ratio. If it is provided as less than minus one, then it is taken as the desired reflux ratio. Reflux ratio is specified value times the minimum reflux ratio. So that means if I say minus 1.3, then it is automatically taken as 1.3 times the minimum reflux ratio. This is normally how we specify a distillation column. Though this is not exactly correct, let me assume for simplicity, the condenser pressure as well as the reboiler pressure is constant at 18 psi. In practice, this may not be valid because there has to be a pressure drop from bottom to top. The pressure in the condenser should be lower than the pressure in the reboiler in practice. But we will try to take care of such details at a later stage. For the time being, I am using the same pressure both in the condenser as well as reboiler. Now, this is how you will have to specify the required recoveries. Now, the light key component, you will have to specify, let us say it is methanol. Now, you can see here, be careful about this. Now, this is recovery of light key component in distillate. That is, moles of light key in distillate per moles of light key in feed. So, remember, we wanted to get about 98% of methanol that is entering into the column should be going into the top product. This may not correspond to the mole fraction of methanol in the top product. Be careful about that. Similarly, the heavy key happened to be water. Once again, try to read this. Once again, the recovery of heavy key component has to be declared with respect to the distillate. Moles of heavy key in distillate to moles of heavy key in feed. Now, we were given this value as 0.01. Right? Remember, this total need not be equal to 1. I may allow 90% of methanol and 20% of water that may be allowed into the top product, depending on your requirement. So there is no necessity that the sum of these two recoveries need to be 1. Let me consider total condenser, right? So let us go ahead. I think we have specified the required information with respect to the block B1 and also for the entire problem. So we will be able to run the simulation. Of course, I forgot to include the mole fractions in the report. So we were able to get the result. Let me also introduce the mole fractions into the report before observing the results. Go to stream, say mole fractions. Once again, run the problem. Now you can see what are the results that are available. We will observe this block result later. Let me look at the stream results first. As you can see, this is the number of moles of methanol entering into the column.
And we said 98%
should be allowed into the top product.
And with respect to water,
only 1% of water that is entering the column
should be available,
should be sent into the top product. Similarly, the balance automatically will go into the bottom product. Now, based on these recoveries, you can see the mole fractions of methanol and water both in the top product as well as in the bottom product. Right? Now, these are some of the other calculations that we were able to perform. We are not practically interested in this. Now, let us look at the block results. Now, we never specified this minimum reflux ratio, 2.3938. So, this has been computed, and the actual reflux ratio, we have specified this as 1.3 times the minimum reflux ratio. The minimum number of stages happen to be about 233. What do you mean by minimum number of stages? When there is no reflux. Sorry, minimum number of stages happen to be when there is total reflux. The number of actual stages happen to be as per the reflux ratio, about 416, right? Now, if you would like to observe some of these results, you can also look at view. Okay, we can request the report options, right? For example, I would like to change some of the specifications, and if I say something like, instead of 1.3 times, if I use a very large value of reflux ratio, what does this mean? 100 times the minimum reflux ratio. What will happen to the number of stages? Let us observe. Now you can see, because the number of stage, because we were using a very, very large reflux ratio, we are approaching almost total reflux. So the actual number of stages will be approaching the minimum number of stages, right? And in the same way, if you try to give a reflux ratio very close to the minimum reflux ratio, the number of stages will be infinite. Let me also run that simulation once again by specifying the reflux ratio very close to the minimum reflux ratio. 0.001. So we are using 1.001 times the minimum reflux ratio. Now you can see the number of actual stages is quite large. So at minimum reflux ratio, the number of stages would be infinite. So this is how you will be able to calculate whatever you require, right? Now let us also see, I'll revert back to some of the specifications that we were able to give to -1.3 and run the problem again. I think we got some results as minimum number of stages as 233 and the maximum number of stages, the actual stages as 416. Remember, these actual stages once again happen to be equilibrium stages, right? So, because we are assuming equilibrium on every stage, so you will be able to calculate the actual stages based on the efficiency of each stage. So, the actual number of stages could be much more higher than this based on the stage efficiency. And I think you can also see the number of actual stages above feed is given to be about 387. That means it is entering on tray number 388, right? So similarly, distillate to feed fraction and other results you can observe from this table. And it was also calculating the heat duties. The condenser duty happened to be 91094969 in terms of BTU per hour, and the reboiler duty happened to be 92689121. In fact, you can also observe this from the table balance. So this is the mole flow, right? This is the mass flow, and then the enthalpy. Now, because we are not actually addressing how the condenser duty and reboiler duty is addressed, there is a relative difference between them. because we are not trying to address whether the heat is added or removed, by what stream it is added and so on, right? Now let me also perform some sensitivity study as is given by this problem statement. You are required to perform a sensitivity analysis on the number of stages as a function of reflux ratio in the range of 4 to 15. I think this is giving you a large number. Let me modify this statement as 2%. 4 to 15 and plot the results. So let us go back to the original statement. Now go to model analysis tools, sensitivity, say new, okay. Now, we are varying, first let me define. So I would like to observe the number of stages. I think though the problem statement is slightly different, I would like to show you. It's a block variable. B1, actual stages, calculated actual number of stages, right? So this is one variable. And similarly, I would like to add one more variable, condenser duty. So again, this is a block variable. Block B1, variable is condenser duty in terms of BTU per hour. Again, let me introduce one more variable, reboiler duty. Again, a block variable. Block is B1. Variable is reboiler duty. Again, BTU per hour. Similarly, let us also introduce one more. Top product purity. It's a stream variable. I'd like to observe the mole fraction in stream top product with respect to, let us say, methanol. In the same way, if you want, you can also add the bottom product purity as well. It's a stream variable, mole fraction, stream is bottom product, variable is water, right? So we have defined all these variables. Now I would like to observe these variables as a function of reflux ratio, okay? Type, block variable. B1, say reflux ratio, molar reflux ratio. So this would be, I think the minimum has been obtained as 2.3. Let us observe it from 2.5 to about 100, okay, about 50 in terms of 5 or 2.5. Right? Say next. Run the simulation. I'd like to especially look at the stream sensitivity results. Now, as you can see, this is what our specification is. Now, what is happening to the number of stages as the reflux ratio is increasing? You can observe that the number of stages decrease as the reflux ratio increases, right? And what is happening to both condenser duty and reboiler duty? As the reflux ratio increases, both condenser duty as well as reboiler duty increases. But what is happening to the top product purity and bottom product purity? They remain constant. Remember, this is a design problem. and we have specified a predetermined separation, the moment you vary the reflux ratio, in order to achieve this required separation, it will try to vary the number of stages in order to get the required separation. Now, if you are doing a rating problem, now this will not be the case. The moment you specify or vary the reflux ratio for the given number of stages, the product purities will undergo a change. So now you should be able to observe clearly the difference between a design problem and a rating problem. Of course, when we go into the next problem, you will be able to do some rating calculations. Then probably you will be able to get a clear-cut difference between what you can do, what kind of sensitivity analysis you will be able to perform using a rating model and as well as using a design model. But remember one thing, some of these calculations that we were able to calculate may not be very, very accurate because we are using certain shortcut methods. We were able to calculate the reflux ratio, minimum number of stages, minimum reflux ratio and so on, using certain correlations which may not be very well accepted. Whereas when you go to a detailed rating model, now you will be able to fine-tune some of these design calculations using a very sophisticated model known as RadFrac. So in the next example, we will try to simulate a distillation column using RadFrac model. Thank you.